last dinner the Chamber holds each year, and it's our annual membership meeting, but it's a night when we give our membership awards and our scholarships, and we thank our members for supporting us throughout the whole year, and we give them an update on what we've accomplished throughout the year. We invited him actually a couple years ago, and due to the golf tournament they have at the Greenbrier, he wasn't able to come, but this year he came. So he was able to work it into his schedule this year, and the reason we invited him is because he is one of West Virginia's greatest businessmen, and this is a business organization, and so we were very excited to hear what he had to say, and he did not disappoint.
Our guest this evening is truly one of West Virginia's greatest businessmen. In May 2009, he announced that his family and company purchased the Greenbrier Resort and the buyout of DPS interest in the Greenbrier Sporting Club, saving thousands of jobs, creating one of the most exciting business deals in the state of West Virginia. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Jim Justice as our keynote speaker.
But I can tell you this about me. I'm pretty simple. I really do put the Lord first in my life, and then my family, and then employees, and then kids. And I don't put kids last, but I just run out of room in my life on what I can do. You know, I can also tell you that I know the difference between right and wrong. And I really believe our society today has gotten so far away from right and wrong, it's unbelievable. And all we do today is what we can get by with. Well, I think there's something really wrong with that. Now, you know, I own the Greenbrier, and that's what you may know me for. But I really believe there's a lot more to Jim Justice than the Greenbrier. But I can tell you, when we bought the Greenbrier, what a deal. $20.1 million. Unbelievable. 38 weeks later, when we had lost $1 million a week, it wasn't unbelievable.
He actually told me before he got up, he said, "You're not going to realize what I'm saying until you go home and you think about it." He said, "In between everything I'm going to say tonight is going to be great advice for your business community." And I think that's exactly what he did. And he spoke from the heart.
I tell you, my dad is my hero in every way. I would tell you that it bothers me to my soul that I'm 61, and over and over and over, for good or for bad, we're 50th. We are. 47th is 50th to me. We're 50th. And of all things, the other day, I'm watching CNN, and they said, I caught just the tail end of it, but they said something in regard to education that West Virginia was 51st. And I said, damn. We can't go down from 50th. And then they said they included the District of Columbia. And I said, I do not believe it. But it bothers me to my soul, because think about it. When I was 10, we were 50. When my dad was 10, we were 50. What is the problem? What in the world is the problem? Now, I'm not a politician. I don't profess to be, and I think politicians, they do great work for us. But you have got to pull silence.